Hello everyone, in this video you will see me start on a new mixed media project, and I'm also testing my own Just Paint pigments in some acrylic binder. I don't know how that will work, but we will find out, and you will see me add the first acrylic paint details on my MDF board, but also the first parts of resin. And so for the people that like tutorials about resin or acrylics, and also love to see experiments, what I'm going to do now, please consider to subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. And don't forget to click on the little bell, because then you get notified every time I upload a video. And that way you don't miss anything. And if you look at the video now, I'm using an MDF board of 30 by 40 centimeters. I've primed it, as I always do, with two layers of gesso and two layers of acrylic paint. And this time I made it gray. And I want to make an owl. And it's going to be a mixed media piece, what I already said. And what I already did is add the first layer on some branches of my own Just Paint pigments in a regular acrylic binder. And what I experienced, that they mix very well in the acrylic binder. And I'm very pleased with that, because now I can use them in acrylic binder, but also in resin. So that's great. And the colors I'm using for the branch is the Golden Beach color, the Brunette, and the White Lily. So I started with the Golden Beach color, very nice, to paint the branch first with a base coat. And in between, this needs to dry, because I want to also add some highlights and shadows. And this will be a longer project, because also when I'm adding a resin, some parts need to dry first before I can add other parts, because I don't want to let the colors bleed into each other. But I made a drawing of this owl on my MDF board, first with a pencil, and after that I used an acrylic marker to trace some lines. And this will be a challenge, and because it's very detailed, and you know, all know resin has a mind of its own. You can't control it 100%. But we will see what comes out of it. Now you can see the reflection of the light in the Golden Beach, very sparkly color. So also very sparkly in an acrylic binder, and I'm liking that very much. So at the end of this video you will also see a close-up, and then you can see in the daylight, and you can see the colors much better. So first a base coat of the Golden Beach, and then I will slowly add the shadows and the highlights. There you can see it, I'm using the Brunette, a nice brown color for the shadows. Yeah, and before I can add some resin details or parts that I want to fill in with a color, I first will add a clear coat on top of this, because I also want to create some depth, and that way the branch where the owl is sitting on is further away, and that's what I want. So first I'm going to, when this is dry, add a total clear coat over my whole MDF board, and after that's dry I will add some parts of the owl with resin. Now I'm using the strawberry, the red color I have in my pigment line. It's for the berries. So my goal is to use different mediums and also testing my own mica pigments in some acrylic binder. I need to see how that dries, and but also to create a lot of depth in this piece. So this will be a longer project, and yeah, we will see what I can make of it. So I'm using a normal, regular acrylic binder, and you mixed a little bit of my mica paint pigments in the acrylic binder. And if the paint is still too thick, you can use a little bit of water, and that's what I did. And then you can paint with it. Now I'm working on the other side of the branch. Again, I'm using the golden beach color and the brunette for the shadows. There you can see it. Yeah, and I'm building it up because I need to let it dry in between. And after it's dry, you can work on it again. All the materials I've used in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with all the links to the websites. If you want to know more information about my own Just Paint mica pigments, then you can send me an email. For the people in the USA and Canada, they are already available in the Etsy shop of my associate Evelyn Schaefer. The link to her Etsy shop is in the description box. It's called Funshine Color Shop, and she also has some great discounts. So if you're curious, then please check out her Etsy shop, and yeah, maybe you can find some nice colors. Now I'm using the white lily for the highlights. There you can see it. Blending it. Yeah, what I already mentioned, for the people in the USA and Canada, they are available in the Etsy shop of my associate, Evelyn Schaefer. But for the other countries, you need to, for now, you can send me an email, because this weekend, upcoming week, I'm going to add them to my Etsy shop, and then you can order them there. But if you can't wait for that, then you can send me an email, and then I can arrange something. That's no problem. So also the a highlight on the berries. Again, the white lily. Yeah, and this takes some time because it's a lot of drying time. Then you need to wait before you can work on it again. But I like such projects where I work more than once on something. more shadows. There you can see it. Again, I'm using the brunette. And then I'm almost done with the acrylic details. Then I need to let this dry, and then I will show you all how I add the clear layer of a resin. So the acrylic paint is dry, and now I'm going to add a clear layer of resin. And to seal in the branch and the berries, but also to create this way some depth. And what's nice about it is that I can still see the owl, so that is my reference where I want to have the resin parts on the next layer when this is dry. So first a clear layer of resin using the heat gun to make the resin more liquid, but also to remove already some air bubbles. Spreading it with my stirring stick. And I'm using the Stone Coat Art Coat. Very nice resin, has an amazing finish, just like glass. And I still have my promo code, it's Petra2019. And if you use that code, then you get $10 off of your $100 order. So that's great, that Stone Coat gives a discount. All the information about this is in the description box below this video. Adding more resin to the sides, and I also taped the back so that after it's dry I can remove the resin drips much easier. Yeah, and for the Paint It Forward campaign, don't let me forget that, I want to mention Doris DF Designs. She does different things with resin and also acrylics. And she does amazing things. And today, Saturday, she also has a live auction. So if you're curious, go check that out. It's at 12 p.m. USA time. So if you're curious, then you can check that out, and I will put the link to her YouTube channel in the description box, and go look at her channel, maybe subscribe to it, she would appreciate it a lot. So working on the sides, I'm almost done, then I need to let this dry before I can add the resin parts on the second layer, yeah, the first layer, but then it's the second layer. The torch for the air bubbles. So we are 24 hours later, and now I'm going to add the first resin parts, and this will be very detailed, and I'm using a very thin stick with a point on it, And with that point, yeah, I'm using it as a kind of a brush. So again, I'm using another color, and this is the Sequoia, also my own mica pigment. So with that stick, I'm adding bit by bit the resin, because I don't want to add too much, because then it will spread too much. That's not nice. And with my stick, I'm spreading the resin where I want it. There you can see it, a little bit of resin, and then I'm spreading it out with the stick. So the next color I'm using is the Blue Lagoon, also a very nice blue shade, and it's gonna be in some parts of the head of the owl. You can see it, I'm adding in bit by bit with my stirring stick. And now with a smaller stick, I'm pushing the resin where I want it. You can see it. And also for these kind of projects where you need a lot of time, the stone coat art coat is great for it, because you have a very long working time, almost 1.5 hours before it's getting or setting, or how do you call it, because yeah, you need some time for this, and yeah, that's why stone coat is perfect for these kinds of projects. Also this color on the feathers, you can see it in the middle part of the feather, because around the feather there will be another color, but I can't add it yet, because this needs to dry first, otherwise the colors will bleed into each other, and I don't want that. So first this blue color, and then I will let it dry. And in the next part or the next video, I will add another color next to it. And also for these parts, I'm only using a little bit of resin at a time to see how it spreads. Because if you use too much, then it spreads too much, and that's not nice. So little by little, I'm adding the resin. Almost done with the feathers. Now I'm starting on the chest, and this is the snowflake, another shade of white that I have, and it has a nice sparkle, but not too much. And yeah, again I'm using my stirring stick. You can see it. And with the smaller stick, I'm pushing the resin where I want it. Yeah, what I already mentioned, you need to have some patience for this, and yeah, but I don't have a problem with that. I like working on these kinds of projects. I did the same with the eye I made, the rainbow eye, but also the mouth I made, and I like doing those projects. To challenge myself to how much I can control the resin. I'm also going to add more branches, and I'm using the Sequoia color again, and yeah, with a stirring stick I make lines. You can see it. Because also that part I want more depth, so that's why I'm adding the branches also on this layer. Also on the other side. Yeah, it's just like a drawing. I'm using my stirring stick as a kind of pencil. There you can see it, making the line, spreading it out. Yeah, with my smaller stick, I'm adjusting the branches a little bit. There you can see it. So for the eye, I'm using the blackbird. For the pupils of the eye, I'm using the blackbird. And it's for the shadows. And yeah, I'm only adding the black because I need to let this dry before I can fill in the whole eye. Otherwise, it will bleed too much into each other. And what I already mentioned, I don't want that. So again, I'm using my pointy stick. And adding bit by bit the black onto the eye. So I'm almost done with this part for the second layer. Then I need to let this dry before I can add the next parts on the second layer. I will also be adding some texture, and because I told you all in the beginning it will be a mixed media project, so that means I'm using different mediums but also textures. And but yeah, first I need to let this dry, and then I can work on it again. So this is how it looks now. In the daylight, in the sun, very difficult to film because I have a lot of reflection of the sun. But that's okay. So there you can see how I painted the branches on it, but also the resin parts. And this is only the first step. In the next steps, I will be adding more details and also textures. And other colors I want to use. Now you can see it up close. Also the nice blue lagoon on the feathers. So what I already mentioned, if you like tutorials about resin or acrylic, please consider to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to click the little bell, then you get notified every time I upload a video. Don't forget to check out the YouTube channel of Doris DF Designs and check out her live auction on Saturday 12 p.m. USA time. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!